Casey Keys News Radio. Let's send it over to your voice of the Teton, Mike Reuter. Teton basketball starts now.
Hey there, sports fans. Mike Reuter coming to you back from the well in Williston. And we did promise you it would be about 23 and a half hours from when we signed off last night. And in fact, it is. We have one game only today. And it is the Teton women's basketball squad taking on the Miles Community College Pioneers. And the Teton putting their 8-0 perfect record on the season against the Pioneers, who come in with a 3-6 overall record, including 0-4 in conference play. We'll take a complete look at the conference standings right now. On top of the heap are these Tetons, 3-0 in conference play, 4-0 in conference play, 8-0 on the year. Next up is NDSCS, 5-2 overall, 2-1 in the Montac. United Tribes is 3-3 overall, 2-1 in conference play. Dawson at 2-4 overall, 2-1 in the conference. Dakota at 5-3 and 2-1 in conference play. Lake Region State at 3-4 overall, 2-1 in Mondak. Bismarck State at 1-6, 1-2 in conference play. And then the Pioneers, who are in town tonight, are 3-5 overall on the season and 0-3 in the Mondak Conference. Taking a look at how the Pioneers got to where they're at on the season, they had a few tough games to start things off for their 2023 season. That was at the Buster Gillis Tournament, dropping all three games, a couple of them in heartbreaking fashion, including a five-point loss to United Tribe and then a three-point loss to Dakota College and Botno. Then another loss against Northwestern College, made it four in a row before they broke off a three-game winning streak against Gillette College and then Dickinson State JV and the Carroll College JV squad. And it'll be two straight losses coming into this game against Rocky Mountain. And then just last night on the road in Glendive against Dawson Community College. That was another tight one, 54-49. Taking a look at the statistics here for this Pioneers squad. They come in through nine games total. They have a 65 point per game average, shooting 39% from the field, 33% from beyond the arc, and 76% from the charity stripe. They pull down 32 points per game and get 11 assists per contest. Looking at some of the individual leaders, three Pioneers are in the double digits in scoring, with one just outside. It's Lainey Smith at 11.3 points per game, Bray Enabo at 10.4, Tyen Graham at 10 even, and Becky Melcher coming in at 9.8 points per game. Looking at rebounding for the Pioneers, as they are going to be giving up about 10 rebounds a game advantage to the Tetons. Yet leading the way for Miles Community College on the glass is going to be Bray Enabro. She comes in at 5.7 rebounds a game. Also above 5 is Reagan LaPlante, rebounding for Miles Community College. A look over at the Tetons, who are perfect so far on the season. They're averaging a monstrous 77.1 points per game, shooting 44% from the field, 28% from beyond the arc. They had a couple of cold shooting days from downtown, most notably when they were in that tough gym to shoot in over in Wahpeton, where they came up largely empty from beyond the arc, but they had a great shooting night last night from deep, and that brought their shooting up about 3 percentage points, so good to see that to start turning around. 66% from the free throw line. They're pulling down 42 rebounds a game, so there'll be a plus 10 in the rebounding margin over the Pioneers, and 17.8 assists per contest. Looking at the scoring leaders for Williston State to see who's filling it in the most for the Tetons. They have four players in double digits. Taylor Moffitt on top, just shy of 17 points per game at 16.9. Kansas, his bad horse, at 13.4. Allie Garcia, 12.7. Allison Kunze at 12. And then Tilda Muritzen at 8.3. And Cammy Harris at 7.6. We know Harris and Muritzen can both definitely fill it in. Muritzen had herself a good game last night, scoring in double digits. And Harris got a bunch of run out on the court. And they're looking for her to come alive from beyond the arc during that Buster Gillis tournament in Newtown. She was a big reason why the Tetons were claimed the 2023 champion due to Harris's sharp shooting from the outside. Now we'll have to see if that gets going again for the Tetons here against the Pioneers. Looking at rebounding per game for the Tetons, up on top of the heap on the boards. It's going to be Allison Coons. He was 7.5 rebounds per game. Kansas, his Bad Horth was 7.3. And Elizabeth Field with just under 6 rebounds per game for the Tetons. Assists per game for Williston State as they're averaging just over 17 assists per game. Taylor Moffitt getting 4. Allie Garcia and Elizabeth Field with 3.5 per game. So the Tetons able to share the wealth. And as we saw, Coach Triplett last night, he's been going with a different lineup, but he's going to go with his normal starting five out on the court tonight. He'll go with a three-guard set with two posts. And so it'll be an up-and-down game. And that's something that will play into what the Pioneers like to do. They're athletic and fast as well. So it should be a track meet here at the Well in Williston. Got a chance to talk to you, the coach before, both coaches actually, before the game. Coach Triplett was not overlooking this Pioneers team who has yet to win a conference game. He says that it may be one of the toughest tests that they have to date so far in the season, just with how both these teams match up. And we're taking a chat with Coach Jenna Bolstad for the Pioneers pregame. And Coach Bolstad saying that she has a lot of faith in her girls, but she was in awe of how fast this Teton team can be, getting it up and down the court. So some familiar opponents, both on the coaching staffs and on the courts. 1 minute and 53 seconds before we start out with the pregame festivities. We're going to keep it, or we'll send it back away to the studio for a quick one minute timeout. You're listening to Teton Basketball right here on Dakota Country 96.1.
For some reason, it's not playing any sound and it's on.
Okay. There's just a few seconds before national anthem. So why don't you send it back to me in 3 minutes from right now? And then just keep it with me. Get a hold of Scott and see if he can figure it out. So I'll just keep it until you text me to say that you got it.
Okay.
All right. So, yeah. So about 2.5 minutes from right now, send it back to me, and we'll be good to go.
Okay.
All right. Thank you.
Yep.
For those of you listening on YouTube, we're having a bit of technical difficulties. Back at the studio won't affect any of the broadcast that you get to listen to, as we're just having some commercial playing difficulties, so we'll get to those as soon as we can. National anthem starting right now at the Well in Williston, and we'll step aside for a little bit of a break while they have the national anthem. We'll be back in about 90 seconds.
Thank you.
Welcome back, sports fans. Mike Ritter back here. We are getting ready to go. Starting lineups for both teams. Pioneers have already their starting lineups in tow. It's going to be number one, Becky Melcher, a 5'8 freshman from Billings, Montana. Number two, Tyen Graham, a 5'7 sophomore from Glasgow, Montana. Number four, Reagan LaPlante, a 5'9 sophomore from Miles City, Montana. Number 14, Bray Enebo, a 6'1 sophomore from Conrad, Montana. And rounding out the starting lineups for the Miles Community College Pioneers is going to be number 11, Lainey Smith, a 5'9 freshman from Miles City, Montana. Pioneers are coached by Jenna Bolstad and Sam Cordham. Starting lineups for the Williston State Tetons is a 5'5 sophomore guard from Granora, North Dakota, Elizabeth Field. A 5'11 freshman forward from Malta, Montana, Allison Coonsey. A 5'6 freshman guard from Australia, Taylor Moffitt. A 5'6 freshman guard from Australia as well, Allie Garcia. And number 21, a 6'1 sophomore forward from Lanebier, Montana, Kansas, his bad horse. We are underway. Tetons get this tip. Elizabeth Field up on top, starting off the first possession of the game for Williston State. Tetons in their green jerseys with white trim. Moffitt straightaway three-pointer, in and out, no good. That'll be pulled down by the Pioneers. LaPlante comes down with the board. They march it up the court, looking to strike first. Up on top, Graham has it, swings it over to the hands of LaPlante. Keeping up a screen up on top from Enebo. Now LaPlante directing traffic, looking for something backdoor, nothing there, and a handoff. Field a little on-ball contact, and that's going to force a travel on Graham. So that'll be the first turnover of the game. 9:27 left to go on the American State Bank scoreboard. Field will get it into Moffitt. He'll hand it back up. The sophomore from Granora makes her way back up the court. Tetons runs the motion. Field finds an open lane to the bucket and lays it up and in. Elizabeth Field got caught in no man's land with the ball and was able to take it to the hole to score. 2-0 game. Tetons on the high side. Graham will swing it over onto the far wing to Melcher. Melcher, shimmy and shake. She's going to baseline drive. She'll float up and get it to roll around and drop in there. The standout freshman from Billings, Melcher, got it to drop, and we're all tied up at two. Melcher was a recruit of the Tetons last year, or this year. She decided to go with the Pioneers. Moffitt now on the near wing, up on top. Gets it to Garcia, waiting for options, swings it to Field. Picks up a high screen from Coonsey. Good screen from Coonsey, up on top to his bad horse. Swings it back to Garcia, open for a three. That one is going to be in there. Allie Garcia with the long range shot to put the Tetons up by 3 points, 5-2. Back come the Pioneers up the court. Working her way around the perimeter once again is Graham. She'll swing it up on top to Melcher. Melcher looking to drive on Moffitt. Slips it down to the high post to Enebo. Enebo, turnaround jumper. That one's good over his bad horse. 1 point game. Tetons still hold the advantage. Back comes Elizabeth Field. Tetons would be more than happy to make this game a track meet early. Moffitt up on top. She's going to curl around, cut off, out to Garcia. Garcia going with a way downtown three. Knocks down two in a row. Allie Garcia with an early hot hand. 2 3-pointers. And the Tetons have their largest lead so far. 4 points, 8-4, with 8 minutes left to go in quarter number one. Over on the near wing, Melcher has it. Looking down low, nothing there. Up on top to Smith. Good ball movement by the Pioneers, working their way around. Back is going to go outside for Smith. Offline, no go. Rebounded by Field. She'll look to run the point. Tetons with good lanes. Now Field looking to fill. She's going to get in there, try to tip it through, and they're going to say no bucket count as Field put it up and in. Contact came as she was trying to come up. Coach Triplett calling for the and one signal, but that'll be the first team, first personal foul on number two, Tyen Graham. Tetons will inbound from underneath their own basket. Four low set for Williston State. Up screen coming for the Tetons, trying to find Garcia. No one available. Moffitt gets it on the baseline. She'll go for a little floater up and in. Taylor Moffitt with her 2 first points of the game. Tetons extend the lead out to 6, 10-4. Back comes Melcher. Guarded one-on-one by Moffitt. Tetons starting off the game in man-to-man coverage. High post. Enebo has it. Working on his bad horse. Hands it off to Smith. Smith crosses over. She swings it into the corner. Graham for the three. That's going to be up and no good. Pulled down by Coonsey. Just about stripped away from it. She'll get it off the field. Falling down is Melcher in the backcourt. Now Field looking to drive again. She's going to go up and too much on it. But it's going to be stripped down. Coonsey comes away with the ball and hands it off the field. Up on top, it'll go to his bad horse. Back to Moffitt. She'll hand the ball off back to Elizabeth Field. Big screen from his bad horse. Field bounce pass to Coonsie. Baseline J up and good. Allison Coonsie gets her first bucket of the game. Tetons up by 8 early. If the Tetons get a stop and a bucket here, expect Coach Bolst had to call an early timeout. 6:45 left to go in the first quarter on the American State Bank scoreboard. Here comes a drive from LaPlante. She's going to be cut off. Trying to get it away, and that's going to be stolen by Field. Tetons force another turnover. Looking to run the court again. Good lane filling. They get into Coonsie. Coonsie stopped by a brick wall. Up on top, it'll go to Field. Back to Garcia. She nets another one. Fly off the front of the rim. No good. Couldn't make it three in a row from downtown. Pushing the ball up the court is Melcher for the Pioneers on the far wing. Quick three-pointer in transition. In and out, no good. Field with the rebound. Closing in on 6:15 as the Tetons come back up the court. Trying to thread the needle over to Garcia. Threw it away into the hand of Smith. Smith gets it off to Melcher, who pushes it back up the court to the near wing. She'll settle up the half court set. No, she's going to fire from range. That's off the mark. 0-3 so far are the Pioneers from range. Teton still holding onto her half-court set. Here comes Moffitt, flips one up. Moffitt goes the distance, puts it up and in, and there is the basket that calls the timeout from Coach Jenna Bolstead. And it is going to... There's an extra whistle on the court. Not sure what that one was, but just official making his presence felt. It's a short timeout. We'll take a short one as well. Back for more Teton basketball right here on Dakota Country, 96-1. We're back here for Teton basketball on 660 Keys News Radio. And we are just about set to go back to action. 14-4 Tetons on top in the first quarter. 5:52 left to go in the quarter. 15:52 left to go in the half. It is Pioneers ball coming out of the timeout. Tetons look to force another stop here. They've been great defensively early. Pass is going to be handed off. Up on top, it'll go. A new sub coming in, and that's going to be a block by Garcia. Offensive rebound and a miss. Tipped out, and that's another rebound coming from the Pioneers. Forces a foul. That one's going to go on Kansas, his bad horse. Second team foul, just the first personal in the game for the Pioneers. Here's the stub coming out of the break in for Laney Smith. It's going to be the new Pioneer.
Mike, we ducked out. We ducked out a second here. I'm playing ad because something's not right with the board. So give me just a second.
I'm still on YouTube.
Oh, you're on YouTube.
Yep.
I got it. Okay.
The one first free throw is up and good. Next one is going to be short. Another offensive rebound by the Pioneers as it is McKayabu into the game for Smith. So the Pioneers looking for a multi-point play. McKayabu has it on the perimeter. She'll pick up a high screen, looking to drive on Field. Got away with a travel, swings through and gets it up and in. So an unconventional three-point play, and that will make it now a 14-7 game. So a seven-point advantage still for the Tetons. They have the ball. Field steps back, gets it over to Garcia, looking on the baseline for Coonsie. Nothing there. Garcia will drive, cut off, over to Coonsie. Coonsie will drive baseline. She's cut off, tries to slip through, throws it up, and that one will roll off. No good. Pulled down by Melcher. Melcher will cross over on Field, just about a travel there. She cupped and hit the ball off her leg as she was dribbling. High post to Enebo. Enebo looking around to get it off. She'll swing it to Melcher on the far wing. Step back, three-pointer on the way. That's off the mark, no good. Tipped away. Garcia's going to come away with it. She'll flip it up the field. No angle to get to the dish. Back to his bad horse. Cross court, it'll go underneath the Coonsie all alone. Allison Coonsie, all 5'11 of her, is left all alone underneath the basket, and she's able to put it up and in for two more for the Tetons. Back to a 9-point game. On the drive is McKayabu, and that one is going to be thrown out of bounds as she tried to drive down to the hoop, got too far underneath, and looked for someone to kick it off to. Another turnover for the Pioneers. 4:18 left to go in quarter number one. So a couple of subs now coming out back into the game is for the Pioneers. is going to be Schmidt. Going out of the game is Enebo and Melcher. The Tetons coming back up the court. Wildner in the game for the first time for Miles. Down low to his bad horse. Drop step. Step through. Up and hoop and the horn. Kansas, his bad horse. Got the call to go. Coach Bolstad with her hands up in the air. Not thinking that one was a foul, and she may have had an argument on that, as that would put Kansas, his bad horse, at the line. Tetons up by 11, their largest lead so far in quarter number one. Kansas at the stripe. One and only shot is up and good. Tetons now up by a dozen, 19-7. Back up the court come the Pioneers. Graham has it, looking to spur the offense on to chip away at Wilson 3. They'll get three and over to Smith. Smith now to Makayabu. She's going to drive around the corners, get down low, kick to the perimeter. Graham wide open. Three-pointer from Tyon Graham in the corner. Good play for the Pioneers to get the good open look. Moffitt now, she's going to drive baseline. Cut off. Baseline jumper up and good. Taylor Moffitt with two more. She can hit from anywhere in the court, and now a lost ball as it is Elizabeth Field forces an errant pass. And that's going to be a media timeout and another substitution coming into the game. So coming out for the first time is going to be for the Pioneers. Going out is number four, LaPlante. Back in is Skylar Newman. Tetons ball. They're going with a stack along the near blocks on the free throw line. Up on top, it'll go to Field. Swinging it over to Garcia. She'll catch and shoot from range. Going for her third. Got it to go. That is Allie Garcia now with her third three-pointer of the quarter so far. Extends the lead out to 14 points, 24-10. Up on top, Smith has it, working her way around. Crossing over on Moffitt. Good defense by Taylor. Back up on top to Smith, working the other way now over to her left. That's going to be a turnover call. His bad horse comes away with it, flips it up to Moffitt. She's going to go up, and Moffitt will be fouled. That'll be number three on the Pioneers in the corner. And sending Taylor Moffitt to the stripe. Tetons looking to press the issue early and often. Just the first one on Smith. And Moffitt now at the line for the pair, looking to extend her already growing scoring total in this first quarter. Moffitt's first one rattles off, no good. She'll have one more. Just the second free throw in the quarter so far for Williston State. Moffitt will have another chance to go 1-1. At the stripe for her second. That one rattles off as well. So an empty set for the Tetons at the line. A rare occasion, especially for Moffitt. McCabe bringing it back up the court. One-on-one with Garcia. She'll back down. Just about lost the ball. Trying to get out. And Garcia now is going to come away with a steal. Trying to get it away from McCabe. And Garcia got called for the travel. She got ball temporarily tipped out of her hand. And stutter step trying to flip it back to Taylor Moffitt. It's a rare turnover for Williston State. 2:54 remaining in quarter number one. Pass goes up on top to Wildner. He'll hand it back off to Graham. Little fumble on the handoff. Taking it back to the top of the perimeter to Newman. High post to Wildner. Looking to work on his bad horse. Going to take the go down and his bad horse with a massive block. And that will be a huge stop for the Tetons. Two more subs coming in for the Pioneers. Back into the game. Going out of the game first is Graham as well as Wildner. And coming back in will be Enebo and Melcher coming in. Entry pass, inbound pass for the Pioneers underneath their own basket. Looking for something down low, can't find a thing. Finds McKayabu on the high post, driving on Garcia. She kicks out to the perimeter, long two-point shot for the Pioneers. Pulled down by Garcia, and she's going to be fouled by McKayabu. McKayabu picks up her first personal fourth team foul, last one of the Pioneers had to give in this first quarter. Their fourth overall, 2:33 remaining in quarter number one. Tetons will be inbounding it in the backcourt. Moffitt sent to get it in to Elizabeth Field. Inbound pass goes to Mafield. Melcher with a big challenge coming up. See if she can't get away with a quick steal and a bucket. But the Tetons able to remain in control. Garcia takes a couple of dribbles. Swings it up on top to Moffitt. Drives, gets in the paint, flips it up, and rattles out. No good. Pulled down by Smith. She looks to push the issue herself down the court across the timeline. 2:15 left to go. Little hesitation dribble. Offensive foul called on Smith. Smith stuck her forearm out to give a little forearm shove. And it was picking up the charge is number 15, Allie Garcia. So the Tetons force the 15 foul. That's number two on Smith here in the first quarter. Moffitt bringing it back up the court, crossing the timeline. 2:06 left to go. Over to his bad horse. On the near wing, looking for someone to curl through. Up on top to Garcia. Swings it over to Moffitt on the far wing. Looking for Coonsie. Nothing there. Up to his bad horse. Now they get Coonsie in the middle of the paint. Drop step. Drop through. Up, and Coonsie is going to draw the foul. She'll go to the line. That one's going to go on Enobo as another Pioneer set to check back into the game. 1:53 left to go. It's been a little bit of a scoring drop for both teams. Stuck at 24-10. Coming into the game for the Pioneers is going to be Tyen Graham. She'll go in for Lainey Smith. So the Pioneers will now be lacking a little bit of rebounding down low. At the line is Allison Coonsie for her two shots. First free throw on the way, up and good. Williston State now 3-for-5 from the stripe. Into the blocks comes Moffitt and Field as Coonsie gets ready for her second of two. Coonsie lets it fly. That one soft off the front of the rim. No good. Pulled down by Miles. They get it over to Makayabu. She'll cross over, runs right into a trap, and Coonsie's going to try to wrestle it away, and they get the held possession. Alternating arrow will keep it with the Pioneers. Good effort by the Tetons, who are turning up the defensive intensity, finding themselves up 15 points, 25-10. Inbound pass coming from Melger. She gets it to Makayabu in the backcourt. She'll cross the timeline under 1:45. Swing it over to Newman in the corner to Graham. Graham back up on top to Melcher. Now to Newman. Down entry pass underneath. Looking for Graham just a little bit too long as Graham had a step on Field on the back door cut heading to the basket. 1:34 left to go. Tetons will get at least two possessions here in the half. Full court press coming for the Pioneers. Melcher getting all over Moffitt. They get her on a high angle pass. Moffitt now pushing it off the court. She'll cross the timeline. 1:29 left in the quarter. Field on the wing. Up on top to Coonsie. Waiting for action to develop. Outside it'll go to Garcia. She's going to drive on Makayabu. Puts it up, and that's soft. No good. Rebound is going to be lost, and it'll be to Coonsie. Coonsie backs down a defender. She's going to be stripped by Graham. Back up the court. Graham comes. Doesn't have number. She's going to lose the ball back into the hands of Coonsie. Tetons come away with the steal, and that's another jump ball as tying up Coonsie is Skylar Newman. Alternating arrow will give it back to Williston State. 1:05 left to go. So the Tetons will get two more looks at the bucket if they hurry here in this. Shot clock going for the 2-for-1. 1:02 left to go in the quarter. Hezbad Horse on the wing. Now to Field. Field looking to put it on the deck. Up on top to Moffitt. Swings it over to Kansas. Kansas looking down low. Long pass up on top to Coonsie. Coonsie hands it off to Field. Little congestion back to Garcia from another one. In it goes! Allie Garcia with her fourth three-pointer of the quarter. Puts the Tetons up by 18 points. 9-second differential between the shot and the play clock. Down low, they get it to Enobo. Working on his bad horse. Back up to Graham. Swings it over along the perimeter. Bounce pass over to Makayabu. Driving on Garcia. Cut her off. Garcia just about got another steal. Makayabu bullies her way underneath and puts it up and in. She has 5 points in the game. 5 of the 12 Pioneer points. 15 seconds left. Tetons are going to hold for one last shot. Currently sitting in a 16-point lead. Field hot up on top of the perimeter to Coonsie. Back to Garcia. Thought about another one, going for a fifth three-pointer to his bad horse. She's going to look to drive. Swings it underneath and can't find Coonsie. That'll have just 22 seconds left to go in the quarter. And we have another sub coming in for the Pioneers. First time entering the game is going to be Cora LaBrie. She'll come in for Jessa Makayabu. Just 0.2 seconds left to go, an inbound pass, and that's how the first quarter will end, with Williston State holding on to a 16-point advantage, 28-12. We're going to step away for on Dakota Country 96.1, as well as on the Williston State College YouTube page. We'll give you the stats for who's leading the way in scoring for both teams at this quarter break. Taking a peek at starting off with the Pioneers, it is Makayabu with 5 points in the game. Tyen Graham has 3 points, and then two each from Becky Melcher and Gray Enobo. Over for Williston State and the Tetons. Leading the way for them is going to be Allie Garcia. She has 12 points, as the Tetons did not go to the bench at all in that first quarter. So Garcia hitting 4 of her 5 three-pointers that she's taken in the game. Taylor Moffitt with 6 points. Allison Kuzi with 5. Kansas, his bad horse, with 3. And Elizabeth Field with 2. So everyone who stepped on the court so far for the Tetons has gotten in the scoring action. There's the first buzzer, and both teams now given the warning. We've got to get going and ready to go. Coach Triplett says get out there and get after it in quarter number 2. It's going to be Pioneers ball here to start the second quarter. And the Pioneers and Tetons coming out with the 5 members that they started, or that they ended the first quarter with. So an inbound play coming for the Pioneers, looking to start things off. So Cora LaBrie in the backcourt along with Graham. LaBrie coming in. She's just a 5'3 freshman from Whitewater, Montana. LaBrie gets the ball on the far wing. Giving her a little bit of space is Garcia. They get it down to Enebo. Turnaround jumper up in good. Bray Enebo over the top of his bad horse. 28-14. 14-point lead for Williston State. Deal pushing up across the timeline. Tetons looking to keep their heavy scoring drive going. And there's going to be a foul on the drive for Elizabeth Field. Picking up that foul, looks like it's going to be Graham picking up an early foul here in this second quarter. Just her first personal, first team foul. That's going to send Field to the line to try to increase her tally of 2 points and put the Tetons up back by at least 15. First one up and good for Field. Completes the free throw, now looking to make it a 16-point advantage once again. Tetons have led by as many as 18 points. Elizabeth at the stripe for her second of 2. That one is up and good. So Field 2 for 2 from the line. Full court press coming for the Tetons. Up the court goes LaBrie. She's going to be cut off. Back will go to Melcher. Back up to Bree. She gets the ball looking for options on the baseline. Over goes to Newman's. Bounce passes underneath to Enable. Swirling it around. Misplaying the ball is Graham. She's able to gobble it up. Over to Melcher on top. Melcher looking to drive. Kicking it back to LaBrie. Underneath again to Melcher. No, it's going to be not Melcher underneath. It's Newman who, with a turnaround jumper, that one will miss. Field pushing up the court. They get it to Kunze in the paint. Kunze forces one up too hard on the 5-foot jumper off balance as she let it go. Melcher now pushing it up, and she's going to lose the ball out of bounds. The forced turnover by Moffitt. They give the ball back to Williston State. In the game is coming Tilda Morrison as well as Cammie Harris in for Kunze and Garcia. So help on the way now for Williston State. 2 reserve players, 3 starters still out on the court. Field brings it back up the court, pushing it over to the far wing, waiting for someone to come up open. Harris gets it on the wing, picks up a screen for Morrison. Behind her back dribble, over to his bad horse. Looking down low, nothing there. Back to Harris. She crosses over, looking to get some distance from Melcher. Swings back to Moffitt. Moffitt cut off, up on top to Melcher. She's going to fly off the back of the iron. No good. Offensive rebound to Moffitt. She runs up. That's no good. Tipped out of bounds by, no, they're going to say it's off of Newman. Looked like his bad horse for Williston State. The last one to touch the ball, but Tetons will retain possession. 8:31 left to go in the first half on the American State Bank scoreboard. Inbound play coming for the Tetons. Morrison gets it in the paint, and she's going to put it up. There will be a foul called on LaBrie, and that'll be her first personal second team foul. Still 8:29 left to go, and that'll be Morrison going to the line for a pair of shots for the Tetons. Up 30-14, looking to extend the lead back out to 18 points. Morrison at the stripe for her first of 2. On the way, that one up and good. Matilda with the first one, looking to knock down the second one as Moffitt and his bad horse get into rebound. One more coming. Morrison again from the charity stripe. Lets it fly. That one will bounce around, roll in from the lip. Going 2 for 2 from the stripe. Tetons up 32-14. Enebo gets the ball towards the logo. Kicks it back to Graham, who brings it across the timeline. Now Melcher on the near wing. Kicks it down to the corner of Newman. Back to Melcher, working her way around. Graham has it up on top. Enebo on the high post. LaBrie looking back door. Nothing there. Harris tips a pass. And it'll go back into the hands of Graham. Graham looking to drive. Kicks it back out to Melcher. Melcher driving. And there's going to be an offensive foul called on Tyen Graham. 13 foul on the Pioneers. Here, 8:06 left to go. That one was a 50-50 call. That one just went the wrong way for the Pioneers. That's going to be number 2 called on Graham here with 8:06 left to go in the quarter. Moffitt will be bringing the ball up the court. She'll hand it off to Elizabeth Field. Across the timeline, 8 minutes left in the quarter. midfield looking to drive. And she's going to have it tipped away from her by LaBrie. Over to Morrison. Underneath to Harris. Reverse layup. That's going to be no good. Morrison gets the rebound but throws it away into the hands of Newman. Trying to find a short angle. And there's going to be a foul called on Morrison. Running down the court was Graham who hit the brakes. And Morrison just absolutely blew her up from behind. Incidental foul. Nothing malicious about it. As Coach Swinky giving her a hard time from the bench. Teton's first team, first personal on Morrison and high post. It'll go to Enable. Looking down low for options across the baseline. Kicks it up onto the wing for Graham. Field pokes it away, but Graham's able to recover. And they're going to call a ticky-tack foul on Elizabeth Field. Field got her with a little bit of a hand check on the wrist. That'll be number one on Field. Second team foul for the Tetons in less than about 20 seconds. And entry pass goes to Graham. She'll work away around the screen. Graham up on top. Over it go to Melcher. Melcher looking down on the post for Enebo. She goes back out mid-range. Enebo knocks down a 15-footer from the wing. And that'll be now 32-16. Tetons still on the high side. Field pushing it back up. Gets it over to Moffitt. Up to his bad horse. Back to Moffitt working her way around. Little weave on top of the perimeter for Williston State. Good defense on the weave by the Tetons. Trying to force it into Morrison. Nothing there. Harris with a pump fake. Crosses over Melcher. Swings it back to Field. Up on top to Morrison. Morrison. Nothing there for his bad horse. They go up and under. It's going to be tipped away, but Kansas is going to flip it up, but it goes out of bounds. These Pioneers playing tough defensively for against the Tetons here, the last few trips down the court. So Taylor Moffitt, no, they're going to say it was back Tetons ball now. So it looked like it would have been tipped out of bounds or thrown out of bounds by Kansas, his bad horse. But instead they say it was tipped by the Pioneers. So Tetons keep control of the ball, 6:53 left to go. So a little extra stoppage in play here now. Tetons looking to put some points on the board. Up on top to Harris. Catch and shoot. One on the shot clock. Up no good. And there was a rebound pulled down by Ty and Graham. Long pass out to Melcher. Looking to cross it over on Moffitt. Back to Graham up top. Swings it over to Newman. Out in the corner. Over to LaBrie. Looking for Enebo. Nothing there to Melcher up on top. Swings it to Newman again. They're looking to feed Enebo down low. And a pass is going to be tipped into the hands of Melcher. Gets it to Enebo in the post. They're going to drive on Morrison. Tipped away from hit by horse. Victor Pocket. Kansas will get it off to Moffitt. Tetons. Another steal as they push it back up the court. 16-20 left to go in the quarter. Field is curl around and Moffitt hands the ball off. And as she does, it's Field's defender, Cora LaBrie, runs into Moffitt, and they call a moving screen on Taylor Moffitt. Third team foul, just the first on Moffitt. Here with 6:16 left to go in the half. LaBrie bringing it up the court for the Pioneers. She'll push over to the far wing. Crossover on Harris. They find Melcher up on top. Catch and shoot straight away. Got it to go. Melcher 4-3. That'll make it just a 13-point lead for the Tetons, 32-19. Elizabeth Field pushing it back up the court for Williston State. She's going to find Moffitt on the near wing. Looking for his bad horse underneath. Bounce pass gets her. Good seal. Hoop. And no, can't get it a drop. That's going to be another foul on the Pioneers. That one will be on Skylar Newman picking up the foul, sending Kansas his bad horse to the stripe. Looking to extend the lead back out to 15 points. Fourth team foul on the Pioneers here in the quarter as Allie Garcia is set to come in on the next stop or the second free throw from his bad horse. First one is up and good. Also, Coonsey set to come back into the game. 33-19 after the first made free throw. His bad horse getting ready from the stripe. Here comes her second one. That one is good. The end of the game will come both Coonsey and Garcia. They'll go in this time for his bad horse and Moffitt. In for the Pioneers, checking in for Melcher. He's going to be number 11, Lainey Smith. And Smith comes into the game. LaBrie has it on top of the perimeter, pounding the rock. Harris just about with a steal there. They'll get it over to Graham. Over, swings the ball to Smith. Up on top to LaBrie again. She'll swing it around. Good ball movement by the Pioneers. The Tetons not allowing any good passing lanes down to the post. Down underneath. A little confusion. Out to LaBrie. Long two-pointer on the way. And that one is up and good. So the first bucket in the game for LaBrie. And that'll knock it down, make it back to a 13-point game, 34-21. Garcia has the ball on the perimeter, give and go to Morrison. Underneath, takes a couple of bumps, and off the front of the rim it goes. Rebound, it goes back to LaBrie. LaBrie working her way around. She'll hand it off to Newman. Newman is going to give it over to Graham. There's going to be a foul on the court called on the Tetons. And we'll have an under 5-minute media timeout. So here with 4:59 left to go in the quarter. Tetons up 13, 34-21. Looking to build that lead up before the half. We'll keep it right here in between timeouts as we have still having some technical difficulties over at the radio station. So we'll be on YouTube exclusively until they can get it up and going. The Tetons have had their way of things in spurts, but the Pioneers not saying they're going to go away easily as they're looking to start to chip away at this lead. Currently a 13-point lead, 34-21. Williston State has led by as many as 18 points. That's been met a couple times in the game. So out of this last media timeout before the half, Coach Triplett talking to his five on, are going to come back on the court. And the Tetons, when they come back on the court, will have Fields, Kuzi, Garcia, Morrison, and Harris. Coming out for the Pioneers, it will be Graham, Newman, LaBrie, Wildner, and Smith. Garcia set to inbound the ball to Elizabeth Field. Field working her way up the court. If this one doesn't end up to be around, Elizabeth Field may play nearly every minute of the game. Kuzi gets a swing pass up on top from Field. Over, there goes Field, baseline drive, up, no good. And it's going to be a scramble for the ball, finally pulled away by Graham. Graham looking to rush. Field harassing her. Up on top to Newman. Back to LaBrie, she'll work it around the perimeter. Back over to Newman on top. Picks up a screen from Wildner. Pulls it back, out to LaBrie, working on Harris, looking underneath to Wildner. Kuzi with a good defensive step, and it's going to be blocked by Kuzi into the hands of Garcia. Tetons looking to run. They have some lane fillers, cross court, it'll go to Harris in the corner. She'll cross over on LaBrie. Pull it back out on top and set up the Teton offense. 4:19 left to go. Field looking for more, to nothing there. Up on top to Kuzi. Kuzi gets it over to Garcia for another one from range, and that one will be just short of the rim. It was online, but didn't get enough underneath it. Back come the Pioneers. LaBrie looking to drive on Harris. Good recovery to cut her off from driving baseline. Up on top to Newman. Dumps it off on the high post to Wildner. Wildner guarded by Morrison. Bounce pass over. It's going to be stolen again by Garcia. She's off to the races. No one can keep up with her, and Garcia puts it up and in. 14 more. And Garcia up to 14 points in the first half. 36-21. Tetons back up by 15. Newman has it on top. Over and go to Smith. Smith looking down on the post to Wildner. Now picks up a screen. Looking to get it away from Garcia. Newman has it on top. Back to Smith. Looking to drive on Garcia. Good cutoff, and Garcia is going to be called for the foul. And she's a little bit too hands-on defense on the drive. And a foul on Allie Garcia. First personal on Garcia for team foul. His bad horse and Moffitt are coming back into the game. They'll come in for Elizabeth Field as well as Tilda Morrison. And out of the game for the Pioneers, we have LaBrie coming out. And back into the game is LaPant, who's seen a good moment of break on the bench. Inbounding the ball is going to go Smith up on top. Over to McKayabu. McKayabu working her way around. Looking for someone to get it off to. Smith gets away from Harris, who went for a challenge steal. And it's going to be stolen or rebounded by Kuzi. And a couple of Pioneers hit the deck as Kuzi ripped it away and secured the ball. So that'll be team foul number 5 on the Pioneers, putting Allison Kuzi on the stripe for one shot. Just the first personal foul on Wildner. Kuzi at the stripe for a pair. She's already 2 for 2 from the line. Coach Triplett talking to his teams who are huddled up at the logo waiting for the first one to be put in by Allison Kuzi. First free throw. Ready to go on the way. That one up and good. Kuzi now 3 for 3 from the line. Williston State back up by 16 points, 37-21. 3:16 left to go on the American State Bank scoreboard. Kuzi readies herself for her second of two. Takes her dribbles now. Second one on the way. Up and rims in and out. No good. Tipped up in the air. Finally pulled down by LaPlante. That'll kick it up. Here comes Smith. Screaming down the court. Cut off by Moffitt on the far wing. Up on top, it'll go to LaPlante. She'll swing it over to Makayabu. Makayabu picking up a high screen. Good recovery by Garcia, cutting her off on the baseline drive. Wildner now in the mid-post area. Pump fake from Melcher. Swings it over up to LaPlante. She's going to drive, tries to flip it up, and she'll be stripped by a couple of Tetons. Out of bounds, it'll go. 2:53 left. Ball go back to the Pioneers. Subbing into the game for Hannah Wilder will be number 14, Bray Ennebo, coming back in. Ennebo's had a great mid-range game so far for the Pioneers. Entry pass set. Pioneers along the corners of the paint. Melcher gets it into Ennebo. Back to Melcher. Good closeout. It'll go by Moffitt. Give it go back to Ennebo. Another 15-footer up and good. Bray Ennebo has been deadly from that mid-range area. And that'll break it down to a 14-point lead, 37-23. Over to his bad horse on top. Now back to Garcia. Picks up a screen from Kansas. Garcia gets into the paint. Little running floater up, and that'll go. Allie Garcia with two more. She's having a sensational first half. Makayabu back up the court to Lewis. Baseline drive, and she's going to stumble, lose it off her foot, and her and Harris both hit the deck. It'll be back to Williston State possession as Ennebo goes and picks it up, 39-23. Tetons with a chance to match or eclipse their largest lead of the game on this possession. Garcia will flip the ball into Moffitt. Taylor Moffitt, the sophomore from Australia, who's the one-time Mondak Player of the Week, on the court with the current Mondak Player of the Week in Kansas, his bad horse. Flip pass over to Moffitt. Long two-pointer up and good for Taylor Moffitt. Just had a foot on the line, knocks it down, puts the lead back to 18. 41-23. Makayabu calling for a clear out. Trying to run baseline over Garcia. She's going to be cut off. Up onto the charity stripe. Gets it to Ennebo. Gives it back out to LaPlante. Up on top to Melcher. Melcher looks to get around. Cut off by Kuzi. Good recovery by the Tetons. Going to hit LaPlante in the paint. Little runner up and good. So a good defense by the Tetons. Just late on the recovery to get back on LaPlante. And make it 41-25. Moffitt up on top to Garcia. He'll get it to his bad horse. Now to Harris. Harris, step up, three-pointer on the way. That's off the mark, no good. Moffitt with the rebound. She's going to get a seal from Coons, and he puts it up and in. And Moffitt with two more. 43-25. Buck 20 left to go in the half. Another sub set to come in. That's Graham waiting to check in for the Pioneers. Makayabu on the wing. She's cut off. Gets it to Ennebo. Up on top to LaPlante. Driving on Coons. Flips one up and somehow gets the English on that one to go. Coach Triplett wants a travel on that call. LaPlante now has scored the last two baskets for the Pioneers. 43-27, under a minute left to go in the half. Kunze has it from the wing. Over to his bad horse. His bad horse thought about a baseline drive. Picks up a Kunze screen. On top to Garcia to Harris. In the corner to Moffitt. Moffitt baseline drive. She's going to throw it up and just about got it to drop with the teardrop. And that'll put Taylor Moffitt to the line for a pair with 45 seconds left to go. Morrison set to check back into the game. Also, Graham now will be coming in. Into the game coming Graham for Makayabu, who picked up her second foul. And his bad horse will check out of the game for Williston State. Morrison coming in. Moffitt's first one up and good from the line. 44-27, 45.9 left in the half. Moffitt on the stripe for her second of two. That one goes on the way. Perfect from the stripe that trip. She's now 3-for-4 from the line. Back of the court come the Pioneers. Smith has it pushing up the timeline. Garcia forcing her over into the corner. Now she reverses directions. Swings it over to LaPlante. LaPlante brings it back to the perimeter. Up to Smith. On top it'll go to Graham. And there's going to be a long throw over the top of Melcher and another substitution. So his guy Morris checking back into the game with 28 seconds left. So come in for Morrison, also field checking back in. He's going to come in for Harris. So Morrison and Harris out. Five starters back on the court for Williston State. Field, Kunze, Moffitt, Garcia, and his bad horse. 28 seconds left. Shot clock is off. Inbound pass goes to Elizabeth Field. Melcher hounding her the whole way off the court. Gets across the timeline. 24 seconds left. dribbling it along the logo, waiting for someone to come open. His bad horse flashes to the top of the perimeter. Over goes to Garcia. Up on top to Kunze, looking for Field in the far wing. Up on top, we'll get it off to Moffitt. 10 seconds left. Moffitt drives to Garcia. Little shimmy to shank, and they're going to get Moffitt for the travel as she pulls up for the mid-range jumper. Got a good look, and just a little bit of a shuffle. We'll give it back to the Pioneers with 6.5 seconds left to go. Have a chance to chip away at this 18-point lead and build some momentum here before the half. Inbound play coming for the Pioneers. Graham gets it into McCaribou in the backcourt. She raises up. 3 seconds left. She's going to look to kick it over in the corner. Smith for three. That's going to be blocked by Moffitt at the buzzer. So the Tetons get a big defensive stand here to force the miss and the block. And Williston State now is on the high side at halftime, 45-27. Tetons coming away. They've had some fits and starts that middle part of the second quarter. They really kind of dried up scoring. When the Tetons hold on to an 18-point lead here at the break. Taking a look at the quarter-by-quarter breakdown, Tetons outscored the Pioneers 28-12 in the first quarter, and just a 2-point advantage for Williston State in the second quarter, 17-15. See if we are still having difficulties back at the station trying to get it back on the air. We'll make sure everything was set off and good to go, but until then, we do have our YouTube coverage on the Williston State College YouTube page. There is about 15 minutes left to go before we get underway for half number two. We're going to step aside for a couple minutes where we can refresh and get the halftime stats. We'll be back here in a couple minutes. You're listening to Teton Basketball on the Williston State YouTube page.
American State Bank and Trust Company in Williston is proud to support area students. Whether high school or college, we salute the dedication of all those involved in sports or other extracurricular activities. Your hard work and dedication show on the field and in the classroom. ASB has accounts to fit a student's busy lifestyle, too. Check it out at asbc.com. That's banking the American State Bank. Member FDIC.
On Sundays, your NFL team is always playing at Buffalo Wild Wings. With 63 HD TVs and your NFL package, do not miss a minute of action. Enjoy wings, salads, sandwiches, and more as your team takes the field. Come in and fan up while enjoying the variety of beers on tap from kickoff to the final whistle. Located at 417 Rieger Drive in Williston, North Dakota, football lives here. Buffalo Wild Wings, wings, beers, sports.
You don't have to drive hundreds of miles to get a great deal on a new or used vehicle. Williston Auto. We're in the business of beating the deal from any dealer. Go ahead, shop around from his marketability. Just bring us their best deal. We'll squeeze you like a bug and feed it like a rich and new. Go ahead, hold her in second grade. You're going to make a compression. Williston Auto and WillistonAuto.com.
Coke Zero Sugar tastes so good, people will take a taste anywhere they can. You never know when your best friend will lunge across a table and grab for it. A stranger could suddenly swipe it, or your little brother might just ask for one too many sips. So no matter what you're doing or who you're with, while you're enjoying a Coke Zero Sugar, be ready to protect it at all times. Because one sip begs the question, is this the best Coke ever? Take a taste of tea.
Of all your choices for a financial institution, clearly the best is the West. Western Cooperative Credit Union is money done the Western way. WCCU provides you with good old-fashioned Western hospitality every time you walk through our door. We treat you like neighbors ought to treat each other, because that's just who we are, neighbors. So head west. You'll know you're here when you see the bison on our side. Join the herd at Western Cooperative Credit Union, federally insured by NCUA.
McDonald's of Williston is proud to support all the Williston State Teton athletic teams and would like to wish them success this season. McDonald's would like to thank the community of Williston and the surrounding area for your patronage over the years. Hey, the next time you're in town, stop by McDonald's for a great meal or a quick snack. McDonald's of Williston. Breakfast, lunch, or dessert, come on into McDonald's of Williston. Proud to be a part of Teton Athletics and proud to be part of the Williston community. When you're looking for a new or a different home, seek the counsel of the professionals at Basin Brokers. Basin Brokers has offices in Sunnywood, Montana, Watford City, and Williston. The realtors at Basin Brokers know the market and will help you find the home that fits your requirements and budget. They're happy to answer all your questions about the area. The real estate office you want to know is Basin Brokers in Watford City, Sunnywood, and Williston. Find them online at basinbrokers.com. From their humble beginnings in 1910 through four generations, family-owned First International Bank and Trust has been delivering on the promise to help dreams come true one customer at a time. Their style of banking places the focus on you first and your overall experience, keeping your best interests in mind and striving to provide smart financial solutions and improve and simplify your life, letting you get back to what matters most. First International Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
So you need a new vehicle. You've done your homework, and a new Honda would be perfect. Reliable, fuel efficient, stylish, perfect. But where do you go? Why not your hometown Honda dealer? Ryan Honda at Ryan Motors in Williston. We have a nice selection of affordable new Hondas, and when it comes time for service, Ryan Honda's authorized Honda Service Center will keep your Honda running and best for years. Come see us today, your full-service hometown Honda dealership, Ryan Honda at Ryan Motors in Williston, or shopryanhonda.net.
Earning your degree doesn't mean putting your life on hold. Williston State College offers a wide array of associate and associate of applied science programs that fit your busy lifestyle. They are flexible, convenient, and career-focused to what your goals are, and taught by experienced and engaged faculty. With 13 CTE and 15 academic programs, you can take classes fully online to meet the demands of life on the farm, in the past, or simply raising a family.
Williston State College, where the people make the difference. Please visit online at willistonstate.edu/apply.
Mike Ritter back here for Teton Basketball on 660 Keys News Radio. We have the halftime stats now, 9 minutes before we get going in quarter number two. Starting off with the Miles Community College Pioneers leading the way in scoring for the Pioneers is Bray Enabo. She has 8 points in the half, 4 of 5 shooting from the field. So a good job for Enabo. At any time she's gotten the ball around that paint, she extends out along the baseline or along the elbow and knocks it down from anywhere from 12 to 17 feet, and she has been deadly so far in the game. 5 points coming in from Becky Melcher, 5 from Jessica McKayaboo, 4 points in from Reagan LaPlante, 3 from Tyne Graham, and 2 points being added in from Cora LaPree. LaPree hit a long two-point shot in the midway point of that second quarter. Rebounds for the Pioneers. Leading the way in rebounding is Melcher. She has 5 in the game, 5 of the team's 16 at the first half. 4 offensive, 12 defensive rebounds. The Pioneers have 6 assists in the first half, 12 turnovers, no blocks or steals recorded. Shooting for the Pioneers in the first quarter, they shot 41% from the field, 63 in the second half. So a big improved second half overall in the game. They are 12 of 23 from the field for 52%. Beyond the arc in the half, they are shooting just 28%. They are 2 of 7 from deep, and from the free throw line, they are just 1 of 2 for 50%. Looking at Williston State in the Tetons, they're led by Allie Garcia's 16 points in the half. She's 4 of 6 from downtown and 6 of 9 from the field. 12 points coming in from Taylor Moffitt on 5-7 shooting. 6 points from Allison Kunze. 4 turnovers in the first half. A pretty good number there. 4 blocks each one apiece for Kunze, Moffitt, Garcia, and his bad horse. And 5 steals. 3 by Garcia and 2 by his bad horse. Shooting in the game for Williston State in the first half. They're shooting 53% from the field on 5 of 28 shooting. 45% from beyond the arc, going 5 of 11 and 10 of 14 from the line for 71%. The Tetons getting after it here. They have an 18-point lead at the break. They're in line to eclipse their season average of 77 points per game. They scored 97 last night against Bismarck State College and the Mystics, and they had a chance to go for triple digits, but Coach Triplett did the classy thing, and with no time on the shot clock and waning seconds in the game. They dribble it out, and the Tetons held on to take the win, 97-61. Tetons looking to extend this lead out here into the 20s or even 30 points before we're all said and done. Tetons back out on the court, getting ready to go, waiting on the Pioneers. It's going to be a fantastic second half as Williston State and the Tetons are looking to advance to 9-0 on the season and 5-0 in conference play. We have 5 minutes left to go. We're going to step aside for a four-minute break. When we come back, we'll have more Teton basketball right here for you on Dakota Country 96.1.
American State Bank and Trust Company in Williston is proud to support area students. Whether high school or college, we salute the dedication of all those involved in sports or other extracurricular activities. Your hard work and dedication show on the field and in the classroom. ASB has accounts to fit a student's busy lifestyle, too. Check it out at asbc.com. That's banking the American State Bank. Member FDIC.
On Sunday, the NFL team is always playing in that Buffalo Wild Wings. With 63-18 teams and the NFL package, do not miss a minute of action. Enjoy wings, salads, sandwiches, and more as your team takes the field. Come in and stand up while enjoying the variety of beers on tap from kickoff to the final whistle. Located at 417 Rieger Drive in Williston, North Dakota, football lives here. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beers, sports.
At the drive, hundreds of miles to get a great deal on a New York City vehicle.
We're in the from Bismarck Village. Then bring us their best deal. We'll squish like a bug and feed it like a rented mule.
No animals or insects were injured while making an impression.
Williston Auto at
WillistonAuto.com. Coke Zero Sugar tastes so good, people will take a taste anywhere they can. You never know when your best friend will lunge across the table and grab for it. A stranger could suddenly swipe it, or your little brother might just ask for one too many sips. So no matter what you do or who you're with, while you're enjoying the Coke Zero Sugar, be ready to protect it at all times. Because one sip begs the question, is this the best Coke ever? Take a taste of food.
And all your choices for a financial institution, clearly the best is the West. Western Cooperative Credit Union is money done in the Western way. WCCU provides you with good old-fashioned Western hospitality every time you walk through our doors. We treat you like neighbors ought to treat each other. With your best gift to the office, the hard work. You'll know you're here when you see the price of the job. Join the family at Western Cooperative Credit Union. Federally insured, thank you.
McDonald's of Williston is proud to support all the Williston State Teton athletic teams and would like to wish them success this season. McDonald's would like to thank the community of Williston and the surrounding area for your patronage over the years. Hey, next time you're in town, stop by McDonald's for a great meal or a great snack. McDonald's of Williston. Dresses, lunch, or dessert, come on into McDonald's of Williston. Proud to be a part of Teton athletics and proud to be part of the Williston community. When you're looking for a new or a different home, you should come to look at the professionals at Basin Brokers. Basin Brokers has offices in Kennewood, Montana, Watford City, and Philadelphia. The realtors at Basin Brokers know the market and will help you find a home that fits your requirements and budget. They're happy to answer all your questions about the area. The real estate office you want to know is Basin Brokers in Watford City, Kennewood, and Philadelphia. Find them online at basinbrokers.com. From their humble beginnings in 1910 to the fourth generation, Sam Jones First International Bank and Trust has been delivering on the promise to help reach come true one customer at a time. Their style of banking places the focus on you first and your overall experience. Keeping your best interests in mind and striving to provide smart financial solutions that immediately simplify your life, letting you get back to what matters most. First International Bank and Trust. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Mike, we're back here for Teton basketball on 660 Keys News Radio. Tetons huddle up along the bench, as are the Pioneers of Miles Community College. Pioneers have a tall task, down 18 at the break. On the road here at the home of the Tetons in the Well in Williston, Ontario Olson Court. they look to try to chip away. Teton looking to keep the hammer down and improve to a perfect 9-0 on the season. Teton will be on the road on Wednesday as they travel to Lake Regent State to play the Royals. And then for the Teton men's will be at home here in Williston on Thursday. That'll be up against Dawson Community College and the Buccaneers. A tough test for the Tetons when the Buccaneers come to town. Over the weekend, on Sunday, Teton men will be in Wahpeton to take on the Wildcats. And then they'll spend the night there, head back over to Devil's Lake to take, over to Botno to take on the Lumberjacks. And the women will meet them there. It'll be a full week of basketball. On next Thursday, the Tetons will be in Wyoming for the Border War Shootout. And both squads will be in action on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. You can hear all the game on the family of networks on Dakota Country 96.1 and 660 Keys News Radio. Tetons will get the ball to start things off. Moffitt inbounds the ball to Field. She'll be guarded by Melcher. She crosses the timeline. Tetons looking to strike early and eclipse a 20-point lead for the first time in the game. Garcia has it, gives it over to Moffitt on the wing. Up on top of Field, back to Kunze. Over the top to his bad horse. Going to be tipped away by Enebo. She rallies it in before it goes out of bounds. Tetons start off the quarter with the turnover. Back of the court comes Graham. She'll swing it over. Going to go through the hands of Smith and out of bounds. So that'll be back-to-back turnovers for both teams. And Tetons will take over with a chance to try and get to a 20-point advantage once again. Moffitt will get it into Field. Bring it back up the court. Moffitt pushes across the timeline against Melcher. Looking for Garcia. Can't find her. Up on top, it'll go to Moffitt. High screen from his bad horse. Pick and roll just too tight of a seam. Kunze gets it, hands it off to his bad horse, who pulls up to the back of the perimeter. Garcia from a long three-pointer. In it goes. Another one from Allie Garcia. That's her fifth three-pointer of the game. She is feeling it from outside. 48-27, 21-point Teton lead. Graham's going to swing it over to Melcher on the outside. They're going to get to LaPlante, and she'll... There's going to be a very delayed call out on the court. Here comes Coach Triplett. He's out on the court asking for it. And the official telling Coach to get back in his box. That was about after the rebound had already been grabbed. So an extremely delayed call here. Coach Triplett still looking for an explanation with his hands in the air. I have to agree with him on that if it's going to be that late of call. What's the point of blowing the whistle or blow it at the correct time? At the line, LaPlante to shoot the first one. That one misses. She has a ball, the second one on the road. No good. Officials didn't wait for Kunze, who's tying her shoe. Moffitt has the ball in the far wing. Kunze gets it in range. Here comes Moffitt from the top of the perimeter. In it goes. Taylor Moffitt with a three-pointer. 15 times. With the transition three-pointer, they extend the lead, 51-27. Back come the Pioneers. That was the first team foul. Second personal on Kunze. Up on top of the perimeter, LaPlante has it, waiting for options. She's holding close to a five-second call, and there is a block by Garcia. She's going to pull it down, doesn't have options to push as she gets it off to Moffitt. Tetons, long pass up to his bad horse, working on LaPlante. Drop step, flips it up and in. Two more for Kansas, his bad horse. Tetons, after a slow start to this quarter of the first couple of possessions, they are a house of fire, 53-27. LaPlante and Smith will hand it off to Melcher. Now up on top to Enebo to LaPlante. LaPlante working on Kunze. Good on-ball defense from Kunze. Just about forced a turnover. Graham picks it up into the paint to Enebo. She's going to be blocked by his bad horse. Into the hands of Kunze. She'll run the point. Now flips it off to Garcia, who marches across the timeline. Under 8 minutes left to go in the third quarter on the American State Bank scoreboard. His bad horse has it on the near wing. Up on top to Field. Finds Garcia. Garcia thought about another three-pointer. His bad horse all alone on top. She fires from range. That one kicks off the side of the rim. That'll go out of bounds. Coach Triplett said, hey, maybe watch it. If they're not going to come out and challenge, why don't you take a step in? So that'll be 7:40 left to go. Pioneers will take over. 53-27. Tetons on the high side. Back up the court comes Graham and the Pioneers. Get it out to Melcher. She'll find Enebo in the mid-range area. Back out to LaPlante. Driving on Kunze. Cut off. Into the quarter for Graham. Baseline drive. They're going to call a foul on Elizabeth Field. So she bumped her a little bit with the hip on the baseline drive. Just the second team foul on Field. The second personal foul on Field. Second team foul here in the quarter. Tetons had No one with two personal fouls in the first half. Entry pass goes into Enebo, stolen away by Moffitt. She picks it up, and she's going to be off to the races. Crosses over on the plant. She's going to Euro step through, puts it up and in. Taylor Moffitt, 4-2 more. Tetons now up 55-27. Steal by Field on the entry pass. Elizabeth Field puts it up and in, and there is a timeout called by Coach Polstead. As all of a sudden, in the first 3 minutes of the quarter, the Tetons have exploded out to a 30-point lead, 57-27. We'll see what kind of a timeout it is. We'll just take a short 30-second timeout. When we come back, we'll have more Teton action right here on Dakota Country 96-1.
When you need a new vehicle, we've done your homework, and a new Honda would be perfect. Reliable, beautiful, stylish, perfect. Well, where do you go? Why not your hometown Honda dealer? Ryan Honda at Ryan Motors in Williston. We have a nice selection of affordable new Hondas. Only 20 minutes for service. Ryan Honda's authorized Honda Service Center will keep your Honda running for the best for years. Come see us today. Your full service hometown Honda dealership. Ryan Honda at Ryan Motors in Williston. Or shop@ryanhonda.net.
Mike Cooper back here for Teton basketball on 660 Keys News Radio. Teton started off this third quarter after they had a turn away and then a sluggish second possession. They have went on a 12-0 run. That concluded with a run out layup by Taylor Moffitt and then a steal on the ensuing inbound pass by Elizabeth Field, who put it up and in for the basket. So Teton find themselves up by 30, 57-27. Tetons are going to back off into a half-court defensive set. Here comes Graham for the Pioneers up the court. Go across the timeline, 7:05 left to go. High post to Enebo. She'll pick it out to the top of the perimeter. Looking for someone. Can't find Smith. Now gets it back to Graham. We're going to work around Field on her the whole way out to Smith. She'll drive baseline on Garcia. Now back down Garcia underneath. Garcia just about got a block on that one. Tipped up in the air. Pulled down by Coonsie. Moffitt gets it over to Garcia. Now pushes it back up the court. Taylor will bring it across the timeline. Swings it over to Field on the far wing. Up on top of the go to Coonsie. Now back to Garcia. She's going to drive baseline on Smith. She's going to go up and she gets absolutely clobbered. No call, but it'll be Field who comes down with the rebound. Field now looking for options. Up to Garcia. Tetons have 9 seconds left. Going to throw into traffic. Coonsie comes away with it. She'll flip it up and in. So Allison Coonsie cleaning things up once again. She puts it up and in for 2 points. Coonsie now has 8 points in the game for Williston State. Graham has it. Looking to get it to Enebo. There's going to be offensive foul called. It's going to be offensive foul called on Melcher. So Melcher gave a little bit of push off on Taylor Moffitt trying to create some space. That's the first team foul of the quarter. Second personal on Melcher. Inbound pass goes to Moffitt. She'll work her way up the court. Closing in on 6 minutes left on the third quarter. Over to Garcia. In the far corner to his bad horse. Looking for Field up on top. Field gets a seam. She's going to drive. Throw it up. No good. Coonsie again comes out with the ball. She's going to be stripped by Smith, but out of bounds. It'll go. Who are they going to give it to? They say it's going to be tipped out by Coonsie. A good hustle play as the Pioneers will be the first one to go to the bench here in the quarter. Coming out of the game is going to be LaPlante. Going back in will be Skylar Newman. Pioneer ball, Tetons again, picking it up at the half-court line. 32-point lead, 59-27. Back up the court comes Graham. She'll swing it over to Newman, into the corner to Melcher. Looking down low in the low floor for Enebo. Can't find her. Smith, straightaway three-pointer. That's off, no good. It'll be picked up by Garcia. Tetons looking to run. 4-on-2 break. Garcia weaving her way through traffic. Finds Moffitt underneath. No good. There's going to be Coonsie. No good. But Coonsie missed a rare point-blank look. Now the Pioneers are going to look to push. Melcher has it. She'll do a little crab dribble, trying to gird around Moffitt. And Moffitt will pick up her second personal foul, third team in the quarter. Still over halfway left to go, 5:20 left. So Tetons will have one more foul to give before they send the Pioneers to the stripe. Inbound pass. Graham looking to find Melcher in the corner. Melcher working, got away with an elbow shot, puts it up, no good. It'll be tipped, come down. Newman with the offensive board, puts it up against Coonsie. Coonsie first faces the miss, tipped out of bounds off of Newman and Melcher. And there's going to be a flop warning called. There'll be a flop warning, I think she said it was number 3, so maybe Elizabeth Field with the embellishment warning. So now the Tetons have to play a little more careful on contact. They draw to stay up as much as possible. Moffitt will hand it off to Garcia. They get it around, and there's going to be an offensive foul on the slipstream from Kansas. Here's Bad Horse. As that's another questionable one. So both teams getting on the short end of the stick. 4:59 left to go. We have a media timeout, and Coach Triplett saunters out onto the court, kind of just giving a look at the officials. We're going to take a one-minute media timeout. We'll be back for more Teton basketball here in 60 seconds.
American State Bank and Trust Company is proud to support area students, whether high school or college, who salute the dedication of all those involved in sports or other extracurricular activities. Your hard work and dedication show on the field and in class. ASB has a coach to fit a student's busy lifestyle, too. Check it out at asbc.com. That's banking, the American State Bank. Member FDIC.
On Sunday, the NFL team is always playing in that Buffalo Wild Wings with 63 HD TV and the NFL package. Do not miss a minute of action. Enjoy wings, salads, sandwiches, and more as the team takes the field. Come in and stand up while enjoying the variety of beers on tap and kick off to the final whistle. Located at 417 Reader Drive in Williston, North Dakota. Football lives here. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beers, sports.
Mike Ritter back here for Teton basketball on Dakota Country 96-1. Entry pass for the Pioneers. They're swinging the ball around, finding Smith on the far wing, and that one's going to be missed. No good. Pulled down the rebound. Deep rebound goes to Coonsie, and there's going to be a kick ball called on Graham as Coonsie tried to sneak it across the baseline to Elizabeth Field. A couple of subs set to come in for the Pioneers after the timeout. Out of the game is going Enabo as well as Smith. Coming back in is Wildner as well as McKeobo. Entry pass goes to Garcia. He's working on McKeobo up the court. It's a crossover now. Puts the brake, puts on the gas, hits the brakes, gives it over to his Bad Horse on the perimeter. Kansas working the way around. Finds Coonsie up on top. Coonsie back to Garcia. Thought about taking the shot. She's going to muscle her way through. Tries to flip it up. They're going to say that's a foul on the ground. That'll be on McKeobo. See if it's her second or third. It's going to be her third personal foul with 4:30 left to go in the quarter. Just a second team foul on the Pioneers in the third. Inbound play coming for the Tetons from the baseline. Four low for Williston State. Can't find anybody. They're looking for it. Finds his Bad Horse. Tipped away right to Wilder. And he's going to have it tipped away. Back in the hands of his Bad Horse. Pump fake by Coonsie. Up and in. Allison Coonsie with two more points for the Tetons. She's now up to double digits and 10 points. 61-27, Tetons on top. Melcher being cut off by Moffitt on the drive. Swing pass out to Graham, now in the corner. They find Wilder underneath, and she's going to be tied up with Field, and that's going to be a jump ball. It'll stay with the Pioneers. 4:07 left to go in the third. 16 seconds left on the shot clock, 4 miles. Diane Graham set to... Oh, they're going to hand it off to Becky Melcher, who'll hit inbound from underneath her own basket. They get it into Wilder. Wilder up on top to McKeobo. She's looking to drive, cut off by Garcia. Second effort will come through, and it's going to be blocked underneath. And they're going to say it hits McKeobo on the way down off the bottom of the rim, going back to Williston State. Just under 4 minutes left to go in the quarter. Tetons looking to continue to extend their lead. Entry pass goes to Garcia. Here comes a full court trapping defense. Gets it off the field. She'll race it up the court. She's going to get it over into the corner to Coonsie. Take a couple of dribbles up on top to Garcia. Waiting for someone to come open. Late freeing up is his Bad Horse. Now to Moffitt in the corner. Baseline drive cut off by McKeobo. Up on top to Coonsie. Now to Field. Over to Garcia. Picks up a field screen. Swing pass over to Moffitt. Moffitt quick three-pointer on the way. Another one by Taylor Moffitt. Tetons raining threes in the game. They extend it out 64-27. Back up the court comes Melcher. Melcher pounding the rock on top of the perimeter. They're going to find someone to come open. Now McKeobo has it on top. She'll pull it back to the top. 3:14 left. Kicks it over to Melcher. Looking to get it down low. A seal off. And there's going to be a steal for a block by Moffitt. And a shot going to be forced up. No good. Rebound this time comes down to Coonsie. Long pass up to Field. Field runs down the court. Bounce pass underneath to his Bad Horse. Lays it up and in. Two more for Kansas. And his Bad Horse now coming alive in this second half. a 66-27 lead for Williston State. 39-point advantage for the Tetons. Up on top, it'll go to Grant. Had Wilder on a curl. Three-pointer in the corner. Up and good for Melcher. That is the first point of the quarter for the Pioneers. Now 66-30. Garcia bringing up the court, working on McKayabu. And there's going to be a foul on McKayabu as Garcia went on the drive. That's going to be number four on her, as now three subs are set to come in for the Pioneers. Out is going Melcher, McKayabu, as well as Wildner. Back into the game is Smith, Enebo, and Labrie. Here come the Tetons. Once again, Field has it on top of the perimeter. Waiting things to develop over to his bad horse. She'll push it up on top. Kunze on top of the perimeter. Takes a couple of dribbles, crosses over. Up on top to Field. Field kicks it back to Moffitt. Mid-range jumper up, no good. And just about getting her own rebound was Moffitt. She gets Smith cut off, trying to find someone to get it off to. Smith finally puts it on the deck and brings it up the court. Field now trying to cut her off. Long pass over to Graham. Just gets it past the timeline with 1 second left to spare. Graham looking to drive. Spin move in the paint, and she's going to bowl over Moffitt. No call on that one. And that is now another basket. Tying Graham with a good drive into the lane. The spin move to put it up and in. 66-32, under 150 left to go. Kunze on the high post, back to Field. She'll pull it back out as the Tetons found themselves out of sorts offensively. Moffitt driving, kicks it over to Garcia from three. That one's going to be off, no good. Field with the rebound, back to Kunze in the paint. Flash to find someone to get it off to. Garcia up on top to Moffitt. They'll reset. A new 20 on the shot clock, down to 13. Moffitt turns the corner. She'll get to the lane. Up and in. Two more for Taylor Moffitt. So good. In motion is Taylor Moffitt. Find her way easily to the hole for two more. 68-32. Smith on the near perimeter. Gets it back to Enebo. Up on top. Three-pointer on the way. That one rims in and out. No good. His bad horse with the rebound. Over to Field. That shot came from Newman. Field mushing it back up the court for Williston State. She's waiting for something to develop up on top. Newman pushing his bad horse. They get it in range from the elbow. Up and good. Two more for Kansas. And she has scored four straight now. Under a minute left to go. Back comes Labrie up the court. Moffitt looking for a poke and a steal here late in the quarter. Labrie flips it up to Newman on top. Now over to Graham. Into the corner, it'll go to Smith. Smith looking to drive. And she's going to lose control, lose the ball out of bounds, and that'll be a turnover back to Williston State with 38 seconds left to go. Tetons will get one good look at the bucket, but so will the Pioneers as the Tetons are getting ready to send the reserves in here for quarter number four. Moffitt bringing the ball up the court. 30 on the clock, 22 on the shot clock. His bad horse working away the perimeter. Field up on top. He's going to find Kunze. Backdoor cut from Moffitt. Not there. Up to his bad horse. Swings it back to Field. Picks up a high screen. Swings it back to Moffitt. She stepped back. Three-pointer. Taylor Moffitt again from range. 73-32. Tetons in a big way. Back comes Labrie up the court. 8 seconds left to go in the quarter. Tetons looking for another stop. Labrie swings it over to Graham. Graham gets into the corner for Smith. Crosses over. She's going to go. Forces one up. And that's hard off the back of the iron. No good. Tetons out to a monster lead, 73-32 after three quarters. And here come five subs into the game. We won't likely see many starters back in. We're going to take a one-minute timeout. We'll be back for the start of quarter number four right here on Dakota Country 96-1. Back here for Teton basketball on 660 Keys News Radio. Tetons up by 41 points, 73-32 here to start the fourth quarter. Tia Conradson up on top of the point. She'll swing it over to Therese Carlander. Working her way around. She'll find Harris up on top. Harris back to Conradson, looking underneath for Moline. She's cut off on the baseline. Back to Harris. Harris going to drive. She'll take off. Going to be stripped by Labrie. Got to keep it with the Tetons. 13 seconds left on the clock. Tetons looking for the entry pass. Harris turns away Conradson. She'll take it. Tetons now along the blocks. Looking for action is Harris. Gets it to Morrison. Puts it up point blank range. No good. Tipped out of bounds. They'll say it stays with the Tetons. And that one should reset the play clock. And the officials now saying it didn't. So no reset of the play clock coming in. So 10 on the shot clock. Four low set for the Tetons. Gets Conradson underneath. Nope, no good. Pulled down by Enebo and the Pioneers. Labrie is going to push it back up the court. 9.5 left to go on the American State Bank scoreboard. 73-32. Swing it over to Graham. Looking down low for Enebo. Up on top, she finds Smith. Smith swings it over to Newman. Newman back to Smith. Gets a screen from Enebo. That one's going to be air ball. No good. Carlander picks it up. She gets it off to Conradson. Adia Conradson pushing up the court. She'll move it over to the far wing to Carlander. Carlander picks up a screen on top. Now to Morrison. Looking down low over to the post down low in Moline. Conradson on the baseline drive, and there's going to be a foul called on the Pioneers. A little touch foul on Labrie. First team foul in the quarter. So Labrie will pick up her second as she'll come out of the game. Coming in for the first time, Jaina Gargallo. She'll check in. Entry pass is going to be into Carlander, and she tries to lay it up and no good. Smith comes away with it. Smith racing down the court. She's going to lose a handle, push away Carlander. Now up on top, back to Smith in the corner. Baseline drive on Carlander. Loses her footing again. No travel called on that one. Up on top, it'll go to Enebo. Swing it around in the corner to Gargallo. Gargallo on the drive. She's going to be stripped. Harris comes away with it, weaving her way through traffic. She's going to attack the middle of the paint over to Moline. Puts it up and in. Alexis Moline with two more points for Williston State. Her first bucket of the game. 75-32. 8.5 left to go. Graham will swing it over to Newman. Working on Moline on top of the perimeter. Underneath, he'll go to Enebo. Enebo is going to be double-teamed underneath. Now she puts it on the deck. Thrown away by Morrison. Back it'll go now to Carlander, who will push it up the court. Reese Carlander slow things down to the top of the perimeter. Hands it off to Harris. Harris fires from range. Up, and that one's going to be no good. Carlander gets pushed out of the way by Graham. And that'll keep it with Williston State. Second team foul on the Pioneers here in the quarter. That's the third personal on Graham. Smith will come out of the game. Makayabu coming back in for Miles. Tetons going four low one more time. Conradson calling for it up on top. She's picking up a screen, gets it back door, flips it up, and gets it to drop. Tia Conradson gets the bucket. Yeah. Williston State up on top now, 77-32. Back up comes Makayabu. She'll swing it over into the corner to Gargallo. Baseline drive, and there's going to be a foul called on Conradson. Her first personal, first team foul in the fourth quarter for the Tetons. It'll be a timeout called for Williston State as they want to make sure they're all set defensively with this second unit out on the court. 7:46 left to go in the game. Tetons up by a bunch. It's going to be a full timeout. We'll be back for more basketball in 1 minute.
Of all your choices for a financial institution, clearly the best is the West. Western Cooperative Credit Union is money done in the Western way. WCCU provides you with good old-fashioned Western hospitality. Every time you walk through our door, we treat you like neighbor, daughter, business partner. Because that's just who you are. So head in. You'll know you're here when you see the price. Join Western. And Western Cooperative Credit Union, federally insured and community. McDonald's the Bulletin. Proud to be a part of Tucson Athletic Team and proud to be part of the Bulletin community.
Mike here back here for Teton basketball. Williston State up 77-32 over the Miles Community College Pioneers. It's Pioneers basketball. Tetons now down into a 2-3 zone. They've went the rest of the game in man-to-man. Entry pass coming in. Good switch for the Tetons underneath, not allowing anything to get it into the corner to Gargallo. Up on top to Newman. Now to McCabe. She'll drive, and she'll be fouled by Morrison on the drive. Morrison shifted over a little bit, got her with a little bit of a hip bump, and that'll send McKayaboo to the stripe for a pair of shots. Morrison picks up her second personal, second team foul in the quarter. Now both teams with two team fouls. McKayaboo at the stripe for a pair. He's two for two from the line, or one for two from the line so far in the game. Now two for three. She makes the first one. She'll have one more coming. 7:41 left on the American State Bank scoreboard. McCabe taking her dribbles, getting ready to go. Here comes free throw, two of two. That one off the mark, no good. Pulled down by Conradson. She'll push it up the court. Looking for some pace. Swings it over to Carlander. It's going to be a pass. It's tipped by Enobo. Good deflection by Enobo to knock it out of bounds and not allow the runout layup by Carlander. Tetons inbounding from their own baseline. Harris set to trigger. Tetons going three low, one high on the set. Harris set, calls for action. Looking for Morrison, nothing there. Moline curls around, up on top. They're going to get it to Carlander. He'll drive, gets to the elbow in the paint. Going to force it over to Moline, tipped away, and there's going to be a jump ball called. Alternating arrow will give it back to the Pioneers. 7:28 left to go in the game. Williston State holding on to that comfortable lead. Early stages of this fourth quarter, 77-33. Monkey Abu bringing it back up the court for the Pioneers in the corner. Looking over to Gargallo. Back to Macchiavo. She's going to drive. He'll go. Throw it up, and that'll be blocked by Morrison. Out of bounds. Inbound play coming for the Pioneers. 19 seconds left to go on the shot clock. Tetons again getting to their 2-3 zone look. Defending against the entry pass. Looking to keep it away from Enobo in the paint. Cross court to go over to Gargallo. She fires deep. No good. Pulled down by Harris. Looking to run the court up. She'll turn over to the left-handed side of the perimeter. She'll slow things down. A little crab dribble. Step back out over to Conradson. Conradson with a baseline drive. Gets by Enobo. Off the glass. No good. Gets her own rebound. That one's up. No good. Pulled down by Newman and Miles. Back comes Graham up the court. Under 7 minutes left in the game. Macchiavu, she's going to baseline drive again to Enobo from the elbow. That one is up, no good. It'll be saved from going out of bounds by Macchiavu, but it squeaks out on the sideline. Back to Williston State. Melcher sent to come back in for the Pioneers. She'll come in for Macchiavu. Also coming back in is LaPlante. Be checking in for Newman. Substitutions are all set now here. As we are back underway, Tia Conradson bringing it back up the court for Williston State. Crosses the timeline, picked up by Gargallo. Swings it over to Carlander. Working away around the top of the perimeter. Up it goes. Harris, big pump fake. Flips it up to Morrison, and just a little bit too much air underneath it. Deton give it back away to the Pioneers. 6:33 left to go in the game, and there's going to be a timeout call by Coach Bolstad and Miles. With 6:33 left, it's going to be a short one. We'll take a short one as well. We'll be back for more basketball in half a minute.
When you're looking for a new or a different home, take the time to look at professionals at Basin Brokers. Basin Brokers has offices in Sunnywood, Montana, Watford City, and Williston. The realtors at Basin Brokers know the market and will help you find the home that fits your requirements and budget. For all your questions about the area, the real estate office you want to know is Basin Brokers in Watford City, Sunnywood, and Williston. Find them online at BasinBrokers.com.
Mike Cooper back here for Teton basketball on 660 Keys News Radio. Tetons up big, 77-33 in the fourth quarter. 6.5 minutes left to go. Miles has the ball. Graham bringing up to the top of the perimeter. She finds Enobo is going to be stripped momentarily by Conradson, and they're going to whistle Conradson for the foul. So a questionable foul called there with the strip. A clean view of it and went right through the ball, so that'll be Conradson picking up her second personal, 13. One more foul left to give for the Tetons here in quarter number four. 2-3 zone protection for the Tetons on the inbound pass. Up on top, over to Annabeau. Just got it on the deck before avoiding the travel. Up to Melcher. Three-pointer from Graham in the corner. High off the back of the iron. No good. Harris comes away with it. She'll dribble through a couple of defenders. Up to Connerton. Will push it up the court. Long bounce pass up to Moline. And Moline's going to be fouled. She'll go to the line. Foul's going to go on Graham. Third team foul on the Pioneers. 6:08 left to go in the game. That'll be two shots coming for Alexis Moline. She has 2 points so far in the game. Sub coming in for Miles. Going in for Bree Ennebo will be number 23, Hannah Wilder. As Moline's back at the stripe for a pair of shots. First one off the front of the rim, no good. Alexis will get one more as Carlander and Morrison, the two Swedish imports, on the rebound line. Second one from a lead. That one up and good. One for two from the stripe. Increasing the lead, 78-33. Back up the court comes Graham. Has it up on top. Looking for someone to swing it off to Melcher. She's left alone. Gets by Carlander. Mid-range jumper up off the front of the iron. No good. Wilder comes down with the rebound. He's going to be stolen out by Conradson. Flips up to Harris. She has a four-on-one break. Running the court. Attacking the middle of the paint. But no-look pass over to Morrison. Up and in. What a dime by Kenny Harris. The Tetons get two more now. 80-33. Back comes Graham up the court. 4 miles. Calling out for a high screen that doesn't come. Looking for LaPlante to come up. Now swings it over to Melcher. Long range three. Up, no good. LaPlante throws it up. That's no good. Harris comes down with another board. Harris looking to push it back up the court for Williston State. She'll bring it to the top of the perimeter. Swings it over to Carlander. Screen for Moline. Now baseline drive. Back out to Moline. Moline puts it on the deck. Up on top to Morrison. Over to Conradson. Drive. Baseline pass over to Carlander. Saves it from going out of bounds. Harris, three-pointer on the way. Jump no good. Conradson just about came down with the ball. And there's going to be a foul called on Williston State. They're going to tie up Reagan LaPlante. They got him off. Got her on the arm. 5:03 left to go. Three ticks of the clock and a stop away from the final media timeout of the game. Graham comes out of the game for the Pioneers. Coming back in is Cora LaBrie. The entry pass coming into LaBrie. She'll take over point guard responsibilities right now. Gargallo has it. Back to LaBrie. Working around the perimeter. Gets it over to Melcher on the far wing. Melcher baseline drive. Swings it back. LaPlante from the elbow up and good. Reagan LaPlante with a nice two-point jump shot. Now 80-35. Harris pushing up the court for the Tetons. She'll get by a defender over to Carlander. Carlander drives up on top to Moline. Moline going to push it over to Morrison. Morrison from three. That one going to be up and over everything. Pulled down by Melcher. Up to LaBrie it goes. LaBrie looking to run the point. Gets into the body of Morrison. Blocked by Tilda. Back up the court. And there's going to be a bailout foul on the Pioneers to not allow another fast break opportunity by the Tetons. Janet Gargallo will pick up that one. Fourth team foul, first personal on Gargallo. You have 4:24 left to go in the game. Carlander gets the ball into Conradson. She'll work it across the logo, across the timeline with 4:20 left to go in the game. Up to Carlander. High post to Moline. Looking for Morrison. Back to Carlander. They have it underneath for Moline, and she's going to be fouled on her way up. Alexis Moline will go back to the line for a pair. So Moline at the stripe, 4-2, to increase this Teton lead. Currently sitting at 45 points, 80-35 on the American State Bank scoreboard. Moline at the line, 4-2. First one on the way, that one up and good. Now 2-for-3 from the stripe. She has 5 points in the game, looking to make it an even 6 if she can knock down this second of two. Alexis, the two-sport athlete for the Tetons, also the center for the Teton volleyball team, who finished second in the Region 13 tournament. Knocks down her second of two, makes it 82-35. Back up the court comes LaBrie. She'll be met by Carlander. Tetons still in their 2-3 zone. Carlander playing tough on-ball defense. LaBrie will get in, trying to drive. She'll kick it back out to Gargallo. Sold it away there by Moline. Gets it up to Harris. Harris looking to push now. She's going to try to corral by a couple of defenders. Working her way through. Up in the corner. Carlander from range. That one up no good. It'll be tipped out by Conradson. And out of bounds it'll go back to the Pioneers. 3:41 left to go. Checking back in for Gargallo will be number 5, Makiyabo. And back comes LaBrie and the Pioneers. Closing in on 3:30 left to go in the game. Up on top to Melcher. Hit Wilder on the high post. She takes the drive. Flips it up. No good. Taken away by Moline and the Tetons. Back at the court comes Conradson. She crosses the timeline. 3:24 left to go in the game. Conradson setting something up. She'll hand it off to Morrison. Up on top of the perimeter. Morrison drives. Kicks to Harris. Catch and shoot. Three-pointer. In it goes. Gabby Harris gets her first shot to go of the game. And the T-Tops love to see her getting it up and in from range as Coach Triple looking to get her going as she had a great Buster Gillis tournament and has cooled off since then. Okaybo has it. Tip pass, but it go up to LaPlante. It finds its way into the hands of Melcher. Melcher for three. Answers back. It's a three ball back in return. That makes it 85-38. T-Tops momentarily were up by 50 points. Now 47. Morrison has it on the perimeter. Bounce pass up to Moline on top. She takes a couple of dribbles. Flips it through over to Carlander. Carlander gets to the charity stripe. Out to Conradson on the baseline drive. Bounce pass to nowhere. Carlander gets it up to Morrison. Eight on the shot clock. Morrison drives. Throws it up. A wild shot. No good. Pulled down by Macchiabo. Macchiabo drives. She's looking to take it all the way. And she's going to be turned away by Moline. Up on top. It'll go to LaPlante. Wilder out on the perimeter goes LaBrie. Long shot, no good. Morrison pulls it down, trigger it back to Carlander. 2:08 left to go as Tia Carlander crosses the timeline. Tetons running a set play now over to Carlander. Guarded closely by LaBrie. Picks up a screen from Moline up on top to Morrison. Down low in the paint, could be tipped away by LaPlante. A 3-on-1 break. LaPlante going to go down and flips it up. No good. Wilder comes down with the ball. It's going to be blocked by the Tetons, but tip up and in. A wild tip. And LaPlante gets it to go. So a wild shot. And two more for the Pioneers. Now 85-40. Back at the court comes Carlander. Calling out directions for her teammates. Coming through a screen is going to be Conradson. Conradson goes through her hands, loses it out of bounds. They say it's going to be off Macchiabo. And that'll keep it with Williston State here. 1.5 left to go in the game. A late sub. Melcher checking out of the game. 4 miles coming back in is Garcalo. Inbound play coming. Harris looking down low. Gives it away back to Moline. Now it's going to be entry pass tipped away. Looking to face it into Moline. And there's going to be a lackadaisical kick called by one of the officials here with 1:25 left. Tetons will get 20 back on the shot clock. Harris again looking to inbound the ball. Gets it up on top to Conradson. Looking to drive on Macchiabo. Hands it off to Harris. Harris will get a screen from Moline. Working away around. Crosses through her legs. Over to Carlander. Back up on top to Harris. Harris holding. She decides to pull it from long range. Off the rim, no good. LaPlante comes down with the rebound. And she'll be fouled by Carlander. Carlander couldn't stop her momentum, carrying herself into, LaBrie. LaBrie drew the foul, so that'll be the 15th foul on the Tetons. 1:08 left to go in the game. At the line, Cora LaBrie for a pair of shots. LaBrie at the stripe for a pair. First one on the way. That one rolls out. No good. She'll have one more. Williston State still up by 45 points, 85-40. LaBrie at the line for her second of two. On the way. That one up and good. 1-for-2 from the line this trip for her. Tetons looking to get it in. They'll have one more play to run. Conradson brings it across the timeline. She's looking to drive back door to Harris. Harris loses it on the way up from the power dribble. And that'll be a turnover back to the Pioneers here. 58 seconds left to go. Macchiabo brings it back up the court. Looking to run what may be the final play of the game for the Pioneers. Looking for options up on top to LaBrie. LaBrie, big screen from Wilder coming. Swings it back to Macchiabo. She'll fire from deep. That one off the mark, no good. LaPlante with the offensive board back to LaBrie. She'll take off, gets up onto the free throw line, throws it out of bounds. With 37 seconds left to go, Williston State will take over. It'll be their last look at the bucket should they decide to take one here. Inbound pass goes to Harris. She'll flip it back to Carlander. Carlander guarded by Macchiabo. Waiting for a curl round. Conradson driving back to Carlander. Put it on the deck. Morrison up on top. Harris crosses over. Picks up a screen from Moline. Gives up a good look at a three. Carlander gets it. She's going to be whistled for a travel. Tetons will turn it over here with 17 seconds left to go. And
And this will be the final possession of the game for both teams, as the Tetons are going to come away with a massive win and improve to 9-0. LaBrie brings it across the timeline. Up to the far wing, shot about a three-pointer. Macchiavo has it now up on top. Back to LaBrie. Long two-pointer up, and that one's going to be no good. Taken away by Connerton. Gets it up to Moline. We'll drill out the last second of the clock, and Williston State comes away with a massive 85-41 win over Miles Community College Pioneers here at home in the Well. They improve now to 5-0 in conference play, 9-0 overall on the season. We're going to take a 5-minute timeout. When we come back, we'll have the postgame show right here for you on Dakota Country 96.1.
From their humble beginnings in 1910 through four generations, family-owned First International Bank and Trust has been delivering on the promise to help dreams come true one customer at a time. Their style of banking places the focus on you first and your overall experience, keeping your best interests in mind and striving to provide smart financial solutions that improve and simplify your life, letting you get back to what matters most. First International Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
When you need a new vehicle, you've done your homework, and a new Honda would be perfect. Reliable, fuel-efficient, stylish, perfect. But where do you go? Why not your hometown Honda deal? Ryan Honda at Ryan Motors in Williston. We have a nice selection of affordable new Hondas, and when it comes time for service, Ryan Honda's authorized Honda Service Center will keep your Honda running its best for years. Come see us today. Your full-service hometown Honda dealership, Ryan Honda at Ryan Motors in Williston, or shopryanhonda.net.
Earning your degree doesn't mean putting your life on hold. Williston State College offers a wide array of associate and associate of applied science programs that fit your busy lifestyle. They are flexible, convenient, and career-focused to what your goals are, and taught by experienced and engaged faculty. With 13 CTE and 15 academic programs, you can take classes fully online to meet the demands of life on the farm, in the patch, or simply raising a family.
Williston State College, where the people make the difference. Please visit online at willistonstate.edu/apply.
Mike Cooter back here for Teton Basketball on 660 Keys News Radio. We are post-game of the Tetons' 85-41 win over the Miles Community College Pioneers. Taking a look at the leading scorers for the Pioneers. Starting off, it was Becky Melcher. She had 11 points in the game. 8 points coming from Reagan LaPrant. Also 8 from Bree Enebo. 6 coming in for Jessa Macchiavo. And 5 from Tynan Graham. Also 3 points from Cora LaBrie. In the second half, shooting for the Pioneers, as they were held to just 12 points in that second, or excuse me, 14 points in that second half by the Pioneers. Shooting in that second half. In the third quarter, they shot just 18% from the field, 18% as well in the fourth quarter. In the game, they shot 34%, going 17 of 50 from beyond the arc. They were 4 of 18 and 3 of 7 from the line for 42%. Rebounding, 33 team rebounds, 9 offensive, 24 defensive rebounds. Leading the way in rebounding for Miles was Reagan LaPlante. She ended up with 6 rebounds in the game. 9 total assists led by Melcher's 4. 20 team turnovers for the Pioneers. 1 block and 1 steal. Looking over at the Tetons in scoring, they were led in scoring by Taylor Moffitt, who had 25 points in the game, going 10 of 14 from the field and 4 of 5 from deep. Allie Garcia had 19 points in the game, 7 of 11 from the field and 5 of 8 from beyond the arc. 11 points from Kansas His Bad Horse and 10 points from Allison Coonsey. 6 points coming in from Elizabeth Field, 5 points from Alexis Moline, 4 from Tilda Morrison, 3 from Cammy Harris, and 2 from Tia Conradson. Therese Carlander tried to get in the scoring book. Lone Teton not to crack the scoring here in the game. For the game, Williston State shot 50% from the field, going 31 of 61, 43% from beyond the arc, going 10 of 23, and 72% from the line, going 13 of 18. Rebounding for the Tetons, they had 37 total rebounds. Leading the way was Allison Coonsey with 7. She had 2 defensive, 5 offensive rebounds. 10 overall offensive rebounds for the Tetons, 27 defensive. 18 assists in the game. That was led by Field with 7.
Turnovers were 17 for the Tetons. They had 8 blocks in the game. It was Moffitt, his bad horse, and Morrison, each with 2. And 11 steals. They were led by Ali Garcia, who had 3 steals in the game. Tetons on the biggest run in the game. See, this one doesn't have big, this stat sheet doesn't have biggest run of the game, but the Tetons started off the third quarter going on a 12-0 run. Looking at some of the advanced statistics here, points in the paint. Tetons 34, Miles 12, points off turnovers. Tetons 30, Pioneer 7. Second chance points, 11-7, Tetons. Fast break points, not recorded, and bench points, 14-9 in favor of Williston State. So the Tetons get a big win here on the road, and they played that second half marvelously, including having all bench players on the court for that fourth quarter. It was a big win here in conference play for Williston State, and now they are in firm control of the number one overall position in the Mondak Conference. With a 5-0 record, they jump out on top by at least a game over Science and Tribes. They're still slotted in at 2-1, as yesterday's and today's games have not been factored in as of yet on the conference standings. That's it for the postgame show right here on Dakota Country. We're going to take a quick 30-second timeout, and we'll name the Williston Auto Player of the Game. We'll be back in 30 seconds.
On Sundays, your NFL team is always playing at Buffalo Wild Wings. With 63 HD TVs having the NFL package, do not miss a minute of action. Enjoy wings, salads, sandwiches, and more as your team takes the field. Come in and fan up while enjoying the variety of beers on tap from kickoff to the final whistle. Located at 417 Rieger Drive in Williston, North Dakota, football lives here. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beers, sports.
Mike Ritter back here for Teton Basketball on 660 Keys News Radio. And now it's time to announce the Williston Auto Player of the Game. That'll go to Ali Garcia and her sharp shooting from beyond the arc. She hit 5 of 8. She's a big reason the Tetons got off to a quick lead in starting in that third quarter, jumping out to a 12-0 run to take what turned an 18-point lead into a 30-point lead for the Tetons. That was part of a 28-5 quarter for the Tetons over the Pioneers. And along with those 19 points that Garcia had in the game, she also had 3 boards, 2 assists, 1 block, and 3 steals. So congratulations to Allie for being named the Williston Auto Player of the Game. And checking real quick at one of those nerd stats that people love so much, yours truly included, is the plus-minus on the court to see who really shows up and showed out. And it was Garcia as well as Kunze who had the top 2 plus-minuses in the game. They're both a plus 42. Right behind them was Taylor Moffitt with a plus 41 and Kansas His Bad Horse at a plus 39. Means when they are on the court, Tetons were a plus 39 in the scoring column, and that accounts for everything they do on both offensive and defensive ends to help their team come away. And come away they did with a big win by the final of 85-41. That's going to do it for this edition of Teton Basketball right here on 660 Keys News Radio. I'd like to thank Evan Scott back in the studio for keeping us on the air and sounding good and helping us out with all those technical issues we had early in the game. And I'd also like to thank all of you for tuning into this and every edition of Teton Basketball right here on 660 Keys News Radio. Until next time, sports fans, I'm Mike Ruder.